Hello, hi everyone. So welcome to Sri Academy. So already manamu so many videos chesamu 25 out of 25 chemistry set lo gain cheyadam ela and so online each and every chapter kuda manam discuss chesam. So online classes kuda. So now we are going to see about what are the previous questions. Mari previous questions elanti questions anedi adutunnadu. So what are the gunshot questions? What are the definitely coming questions? Very, very, very important questions. What are these questions? Okay? Ante, ippudu manaku ee set lo chemistry lo especially in chemistry, total 25 questions are there. In these 25 questions, most of the questions are repeated. Same model questions will come. ఓకే సో ఏదైతే మోడల్ ఉంటుందో అదే మోడల్ క్వశ్చన్ అనేది మళ్ళీ వస్తుంది సో సేమ్ మోడల్ వాల్యూస్ మాత్రమే చేంజ్ అవుతాయి అలా ఎన్ని క్వశ్చన్స్ ఉంటాయి సో సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేటివి ఆ సేమ్ మోడల్ క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేటివి వచ్చేస్తాయి మనకు ఓకే సేమ్ మోడల్ క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేసి వచ్చేస్తాయి సో అలా సేమ్ మోడల్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఎక్కడ ఏ చాప్టర్ నుండి ఏ క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేటివి ఇంపార్టెంట్ అనేది మనం ఆల్రెడీ వీడియోస్లో చూసాం మరి మనకు ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ పేపర్స్లో సాల్వ్ చేస్తే సో ఈ 4 or 5 ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ మనకు మనం కంప్లీట్గా థరోగా ఉంటే డెఫినెట్లీ వీ విల్ గెట్ 20 క్వశ్చన్స్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 25 ఓకే అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 25 ఈ ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ నుండి సేమ్ మోడల్ క్వశ్చన్స్ 20 క్వశ్చన్స్ కవర్ అవుతాయి సో ఆర్ యూ రెడీ టు కంప్లీట్ దిస్ ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ నౌ ఎస్ ఓకే సో ఈ ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ 1 by 1 చూద్దాం సో ఈ ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ మనం కంప్లీట్ చేసినట్లయితే సో అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 25 క్వశ్చన్స్ మనం కెమిస్ట్రీలో కంప్లీట్ చేసినట్లయితే సో కంప్లీట్ చేసినట్లు ఉంటుంది ఓకే సో డెఫినెట్లీ సో మనం వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ క్వశ్చన్సే మనం ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ లాగా వస్తాయి కాబట్టి ఆ క్వశ్చన్స్ అన్నిటిని కూడా మనం కవర్ చేయాలి సో ఎలాంటి క్వశ్చన్స్ వస్తున్నాయో మన మైండ్లో మనకు ఫిక్స్ అయిపోయి ఉండాలి సో ఎవ్రీ స్టూడెంట్ కూడా ఇక్కడ ఈ చాప్టర్ నుండి ఈ క్వశ్చన్కి వస్తుంది ఈ చాప్టర్ నుండి ఈ క్వశ్చన్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్లో వస్తుంది అనే మైండ్ సెట్లో మీరు ఎగ్జామినేషన్కి వెళ్ళాల్సిన అవసరం ఉంటుంది ఎప్పుడు ఆ విధంగా ఎగ్జామినేషన్కి వెళ్తారు డెఫినెట్లీ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఫాలోయింగ్ దీస్ గన్ షాట్ క్వశ్చన్స్ then you will be thorough in chemistry so out of 25 20 to 25 sometimes 25 out of 25 వస్తాయి so మరి చూద్దామా yes we will see so let us take the first question very very important question most of the time they are asking what is the question now so the question is when an electron drops from 4s orbital to 2s orbital in an hydrogen atom the frequency of radiation emitted belongs to which region like this question they are asking So, first of all, we have to analysis what is the question they asked. When an electron drops from 4s orbital to 2s orbital in an hydrogen. So, I am taking hydrogen. This is the nucleus of hydrogen. So, in this hydrogen, how many orbits are there? Only one orbit because hydrogen atomic number is equal to 1. Then, electronic configuration is equal to 1s1 is it right or wrong yes right next now what about the question when an electron drops from 4s orbital to 2s orbital so we need to take so 2s and 3s after that 4s orbital so one electron is dropping from 4s orbital so see here I am taking 1s here means s orbital is present in first orbit and 2s s orbital is present in second orbit and 3s s orbital is present in the third orbit at the p orbital starts with 2p and here 3p 3d also present 4s okay now this is the orbital orientation now what they are saying that when an electron drops from 4s orbital to 2s orbital electron is present in this 4s now it is jumping from 4s to 2s orbital from here to here jumping takes place in an hydrogen atom the frequency of radiation emitted belongs to which region they are asking so frequency is which region so very simple in hydrogen spectrum we know very well that this is the hydrogen spectrum 1 2 3 4 5 6 n is equal to 1 n is equal to 2 n equal to 3 n equal to 4 n equal to 5 n is equal to 6 let it is nucleus now this is the nucleus first orbit, second orbit, third orbit, fourth orbit, fifth orbit, sixth orbit. Say whenever all the electrons are reaching to n is equal to 1, whenever all the electrons are reaching to n is equal to 1, what it is called? Lyman series. What it is called? Lyman. Generally, Lyman series is observed in what? Ultraviolet radiation, UV radiation, ultraviolet region. Whenever n is equal to 2, whenever all the electrons are coming into n is equal to 2 level, then it is called as Balmer series, B-A-L-M-E-R, Balmer. So, Balmer series is observed in which region? Visible radiation, visible region. So, that is the question and answer is came here. So, 4s2, what is they are saying? 4s2, 2s. So, this is the 4s2 whenever it is coming to 2s. So, we know very well that this is the Lyman series, it is the Balmer series. And what about this one? This is the Paschen. It is bracket. And this is the fund. You know very well all these things. Now, what is the question they are asking? The question you observe. When an electron drops from 4s orbital to 2s orbital, so n is equal to 4 to n is equal to 2. Whenever electron is jumping from n is equal to 4 to 2, what is the series? It is Balmer series. Where it is observing? Visible radiation. So that is the question. Ultraviolet. Ultraviolet means n is equal to 1. Lyman. It's not answer. Visible region. Yes, this is the answer. What about infrared microwave? So this is IR. All these are infrared. 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 It means whenever electron drops to the n is equal to 1, UV radiation, UV, it is UV. Whenever n is equal to 2, visible radiation. N is equal to 3, IR. N is equal to 4, 5. And this is also IR, IR. Okay. So, our answer is visible region. Why? Because electron is jumping from 4 to 2. Either 4 to 2 or 5 to 2 or 6 to 2 or 7 to 2. Or 3 to 2, whatever it may be, if electron is coming to the second, then it will be Balmer series absorbed in visible radiation. Okay, based on this diagram. So, here also 4s2, 2 means it is which region? Visible radiation. Only using visible radiation only, we can able to see this Balmer series. Okay, ante manam Lyman series ni chudalante UV radiations ni use cheyali. Visible radiation chudalante Balmer series ni use cheyali. Aa vidhanga based on that one we can easily answer. Our answer is visible region. See how much it is easy. So let us take the next question. What is the next question? Which of the following is true about ionic compounds? Okay, so see here, which of the following is true about ionic compounds? So what are the different types of answers? Ionic compounds conduct electricity when dissolved in water. Second option, ionic compounds are not soluble in water. Option C, ionic compounds are crystalline solids. Option D, ionic compounds conduct electricity when dissolved in water and ionic compounds are crystalline solids. So these are the different types of options they are given. So first of all, what is the question they are asking? Which of the following is true about ionic compound? That is the question. So what is ionic compounds? Ionic compound means, it is, example is, I am taking NaCl. So Na, sodium is in the form of plus and chlorine is in the form of minus. Now, as electrostatic force present between two oppositely charged ions is called as ionic bond. Okay, so what is ionic bond? So electrostatic force, strong electrostatic force. Strong electrostatic force present between two oppositely charged ions is called as ionic bond. So based on that one, let us take what are the different types. Which of the following is true about ionic compounds? Ionic compounds conduct electricity when dissolved in water. Next, ionic compounds are not soluble in water. It is soluble in water, so it's not a right option. Next, ionic compounds are crystalline solids. Ionic compounds conduct electricity when dissolved in water and ionic compounds are crystalline solids. So fourth option is right, because it is the crystalline solids. What are the characteristics? It is crystalline solids and dissolved in water, because it is dissolved in polar compounds, because it is also one of the polar compound. So our answer is ionic compounds conduct electricity when dissolved in water. So when ionic compound if you are taking, that is conducting electricity only whenever you are dissolving inside the water. Okay, for example, sodium chloride I am taking here. This sodium chloride we are dissolving in this water. In this water we are sodium chloride is dissolving. It is in the form of Na plus and Cl minus. Then sodium chloride solution is formed here. Then automatically it is a good conductor of electricity. It is a good conductor of electricity because it is a polar compound and water is also polar. So always ionic compounds are dissolved in polar solvents. So both are polar, then automatically it is easily conduct the electricity. So ionic compounds conduct electricity when dissolved in water and ionic compounds are crystalline solids. So this is about the answer. So let us take one more important question is oxidation state of iron in Fe3O4 is. So chala times examination lo AP set lo gaani and vidhanga Telangana set lo gaani observe chesinatlayite ee question adigadu. What is the question they asked? Oxidation state of iron in Fe3O4, iron oxide Fe3O4. So what is the oxidation state of iron here? So Fe3O4 iskunatlayite Fe3O4, it means three atoms of iron is present, 4 atoms of oxygen are present. So this we can write in this form of a form lo untundi idi FeO comma Fe2O3 formation lo untundi. Fe3O4 ante it is in the form of FeO plus Fe2O3. Yes, so iron oxidation state is what? What is the iron oxidation state? Plus 2. What is the iron oxidation state? Plus 3. Okay, it is minus 2. Okay, it is plus 2. Oxygen is minus 2. It means, ee vidhanga manam oxidation state ni calculate chesukovali. First, Fe3O4 ni divide chesthe idi A form lo undi, FeO form lo undi, Fe2O3 form lo undi. Fe3O4 FeO form lo undi, Fe2O3 form lo undi. So FeO ante Fe plus 2 form, O minus 2 form. And O anedi plus 3 form, it is a minus 2 form. Minus 2 ikkada vachesindi, plus 3 ikkadiki vachesindi. Okay, next. So ikkada manamu chusinatlayite iron is plus 2, iron is plus 3. So how many irons are plus 2 here? So plus 2 any irons unnai? Okay, iron. Plus 3 any unnai? Plus 3, plus 3. Because 2 irons are present in plus 3. Total how many? 3. So by 3 jeddam. Then plus 2 plus 3 plus means plus 8 divided by 3. So this is the oxidation state of iron. What is the answer? Plus 8 by 3 anamata. So that is the answer. So very simple. It is in the form of FeO and Fe2O3. One is in the form of plus 2. Second one is in the form of plus 3. Plus 2 plus 3 plus 3 by 3. Plus 8 by 3. Note it down clearly. So see next question. In a sample of salt water, NaCl would be considered as. So what is solution generally? A sum of salt plus solvent equal to solution. Okay. So we can say that solute plus solvent, the combination solute plus solvent is equal to, what is the answer now? Solution. Solution is nothing but solute plus solvent. Yes, yes. So in a sample of salt water, NaCl would be considered as. So NaCl, for example, salt water iskunam ikkada. So first of all, I am taking the water. So this is the water content. So what we have added here? NaCl, sodium chloride is added. Now it is acting as solute, this is acting as water. What is solute? Whichever is a less amount, that is called as solute. Whichever is the maximum amount, that is called as solvent. So it is acting as solute. NaCl is the solute and water is solvent. Very easiest question. This is also previous question. Next, What is the next previous question? Laboratory gas is obtained by cracking. So laboratory gas is obtained by cracking what? Coal or diesel oil, petrol or kerosene oil? Kerosene oil. Okay, so laboratory gas is obtained by the cracking of kerosene oil. Kerosene oil ni manam crack chesthe manaku laboratory oil anedi vastundi. Next, in CVH, when the concentration of decomposable organic matter is large, then ante, so when the CVH, when the concentration of decomposable organic matter is large, so whenever we are taking, for example, this is the lake, inside this is lake, so many organisms are there, microorganisms. Okay, whenever the microorganisms are more, then automatically what will happen? Let it is sewage. So when the concentration of decomposable organic matter is large, then BOD value is high, as well as BOD value is high, as well as COD value is also high. How can you say BOD? What is BOD? Biological oxygen demand. What is COD? Chemical oxygen demand. So whenever inside this water biological organisms is developed due to the developing of wastage materials, whenever the wastage materials are increasing, then automatically the biological oxygen demand also will increase, because wastage increase avutunte organisms aneti develop avutuntai. So organisms develop avutunte organisms ki manaku breathing purpose kem kavali, oxygen kavali. So oxygen demand anedi increase avutundi. So that is called as biological oxygen demand, BOD. So what is COD? Chemical oxygen demand. So here it is also required some amount of oxygen, that is called as chemical oxygen demand. So this question is having two kinds of answer, BOD and COD value is high. So A answer ichina manaku marks aneti add cheyadam jarugutundi. Okay, note it down. So let us take the next question. What is the next question? Choose the correct statement from given options below for the equilibrium. HClO4 plus H2O gives H3O plus ClO4 minus. So this is the equilibrium is given. HClO4 plus water, what it is giving? It is donating H plus ion. It is donating H plus ion to the water. Then it becomes as H3O plus ClO4 minus. Choose the correct statement from given options below for the equilibrium. Which of the following is right one? So we know very well is that conjugate acid base theory we need to know. What is the conjugate acid? Whenever you are adding H plus ion plus H plus ion, then it is giving what? It is giving conjugate acid. So minus H plus ion, it is giving conjugate base. This is the short logic we need to catch here. So okate manaku logic em gurtu pettukovali, any compound you take, if you are adding H plus ion, then it will becomes as conjugate acid. If you are removing H plus ion from this one, it is giving conjugate base. Okay, ante enti, edaina compound iskondi H plus ion ni add chesthe vache danni em anjuttunam, conjugate acid. H plus ion ni remove chesthe vache danni em anjuttunam, conjugate base. Okay, yes. So see here, HCl4 is the conjugate acid of water. Is it right? No. So HClO4 lo Cl undi, complete different. It is complete different. So conjugate acid base pair ante only one H plus ion is different. So the pair which differ by one H plus ion, that is only called as conjugate acid base pair. See, okay, H plus ion maatrame difference undali. Ikkada so many elements are different, so it is not a right answer. Okay, next. H3O plus is the conjugate base of H2O. Conjugate base ante enti, H plus ion ni remove chesthe vachedani conjugate base antunnam. But what about this option? H2O, we are added the H plus ion, then only it will become such H3O plus. So it is also not right answer, because H2O plus is the conjugate base. It's not conjugate base, it is the conjugate acid of H2O. So it is also not right answer. Next, H2O is the conjugate acid of H3O plus. Okay, so conjugate acid of H3O plus, it is also not right answer, because H2O, to the H2O, this is the conjugate acid. So whenever you are adding 1H plus ion, then it will becomes as H3O plus. So to the water, what is the conjugate acid? H3O plus. Now ClO4 minus is the conjugate base of HClO4. Yes. So whenever you are removing H plus ion, it will becomes as a ClO4 minus. Okay. So ClO4 minus is the conjugate base of, conjugate base antenti H plus ion ni. So conjugate base of HClO4 minus, minus H plus ikkandi manaku HClO4 diskoni enjasunam H plus ion remove chesochedanni conjugate base. So this is our right option. Okay, so what is conjugate acid base pair? Which differ by one proton, that is called as conjugate acid base pair. Okay, so in between HClO4 and HClO4 minus. The next question is, what volume of 12.6 molar HCl must be added to enough water to prepare 5 liter of 3 molar HCl? What are the options is given? 21 liters, 0.840 liters, 1.19 liters, 7.56 liters. These are the different kinds of options. So for this one, so see, what volume of 12.6 molar HCl must be added to enough water to prepare 5 liters of 3 molar HCl? So what I am taking now, I am taking one vessel now. Yes, this is the vessel. So in this vessel, see, this is the vessel. So in this vessel, how much amount quantity of liquid we are having? 12.6 molar HCl must be added to enough water to prepare 5 liters of 3 molar HCl. So we can use M1V1 is equal to M2V2. What is the M1 is given? 12.6 into V1 we need to calculate, and M2 is equal to, that is 3 molar. What is M2? 3 molar. And what is the final volume? That is 5 molar. 3 into 5, 15. So V1 is equal to 15 divided by 12.6. Okay, 15 divided by 12.6. So what volume of 12.6 molar HCl must be added to enough water to prepare? So V2, V means final volume we need to calculate. So you can take V1, V2, anything. So final volume, this is a simplification. So finally we will get that. So how many times it is? 1.19 liters. This is our answer. Okay, so very simple. Initial ga entundi manaku concentration enta? So 12.6 liters undi, 12.6 molar. So into V1 equal to 3 into 5, M1 V1 equal to M2 V2 follow up chesesi manaku final volume enta varaku aithe make up cheyalo aa question anesi answer adugutunnadu. So answer is the 1.19 liters. Note it down clearly. So see, the next question is, the basis of reverse osmosis is. So what is osmosis? What is reverse osmosis? So see here, osmosis process first chuddam. So one container we are taking, so we are dividing with two half parts with semi permeable membrane. This is SPM. What it called? SPM, semi permeable membrane. So left hand side I am taking one liquid, let it is C1 concentration, and right hand side I am taking one more solution, that it is the C2 concentration. For example, this concentration is very high, let it is, this is the concentration is very high, this is the higher concentrated solution compared with the, this is the lower concentrated solution. Okay, so now whenever you are applying a piston in the left hand side, left hand side whenever you are applying the piston using piston pressure, solvent particles are moving from left to right, that is called as osmosis process. So osmosis process ante ikkada lower concentration to higher concentration anedi manaku solvent particles aneti move avutavi. Okay, so the moving of solvent particles through semi-permeable membrane from lower concentration to higher concentration, from lower concentrated solvent to higher concentrated solvent solution, that is called osmosis process. Now what is reverse osmosis? Reverse osmosis means now we have to apply pressure. On this side, which side? High concentrated containing solution side. Then automatically what will happen? Now solvent particles, only solvent particles, not solute particles. Solvent particles are, due to the presence of this external pressure, it is moving from higher concentrated to lower concentration side. Okay, so moving from higher concentrated to lower concentration side, solvent particle movement takes place through this SPM, semi-permeable membrane. So that is called as reverse osmosis process. What is osmosis? Osmosis ante solvent particles aneti, so low concentrated nundi high concentrated ki move out there, that is called as osmosis process. So what is reverse osmosis? Reverse osmosis means movement of this solvent particles from high concentrated to low concentrated one. So from high concentrated solution to low concentrated solution through semi-permeable membrane. What, which one? That is solvent particles, that is called as reverse osmosis. So ikkada one by one option chusam. So the basis of reverse osmosis, so reverse osmosis condition, osmotic pressure greater than hydrostatic pressure. So this is hydrostatic pressure, upside pressure, piston pressure is called as hydrostatic pressure. So inside whatever you are having, that pressure is called as hydrostatic pressure. So it is not right option. Next, osmotic pressure equal to hydrostatic pressure. Whenever osmotic pressure equal to hydrostatic pressure, the piston cannot move anywhere. Next, if hydrostatic pressure is greater than osmotic pressure, so hydrostatic pressure means upside pressure is very very high, then only these solvent particles can move from right to left side. So which option is right here? Third option is right. What is the third option explanation here? Hydrostatic pressure is greater than osmotic pressure. Yes. So whenever hydrostatic pressure is maximum upon the piston, it will come downside, then automatically pressure exhibiting on this solution will be more compared with this one. So solvent particles, whatever you are having in this side, is moving through this SPM, semi-permeable membrane, from right to left. So what is reverse osmosis? Means the movement of solvent particles from high concentrated solution to low concentrated solution is called as reverse osmosis process. That is, external pressure should be more, that is called as hydrostatic pressure. So always hydrostatic pressure should be greater than osmotic pressure. So that is the right answer. Very simple concept. Okay, if you want to take the osmotic pressure, osmosis process, in osmosis process first option is right, osmotic pressure is greater than hydrostatic pressure. Okay, yes. Now it's next question, a thermoplastic is formed by the phenomena of chain polymerization, condensation polymerization, chlorination, nitration. What is the meaning of condensation polymerization? So polymerization means two monomers are combining with each other to form a polymer. Okay, so condensation polymer means whenever two monomers are combining with each other, some small molecules are going to remove, like water, ammonia, like these kind of molecules are going to remove, then it is called as condensation. Whenever two molecules are going to add, some small molecules are going to remove here, then it is called as condensation polymerization. Chain polymerization. Chain means pi bonds are going to break and new sigma bonds are going to form. Here there is no removal of any small molecules. That is called as chain polymerization. Now, a thermoplastic is formed by the phenomena of, what is the answer? Chain polymerization. Okay, it is thermoplastic always. Chain polymerization and thermosetting polymerization is condensation polymerization. Okay, so this is for thermosetting. This is for thermoplastic. Okay, yes, note it down clearly.